Welcome back to Nurse Horizon Online, Mock Test Series 2. Today, we are discussing 30 challenging questions from all nursing subjects. So, let us start. Question number 1. Which of the following is true regarding cold application? Option A. Increases blood flow. B. Used for chronic pain. C. Helps the muscle to relax. D. Reduces the inflammation. Answer. Option D. Reduces the inflammation. Rationale. Cold application decreases the blood flow, reduces the inflammation, and should be applied within 48 hours of the injury, such as sprain. But in heat application, it increases the blood flow, relaxes the muscle, and effective in chronic pain. Question number 2. A patient complains of dribbling of urine. Which of the following action would be the best action? Option A. Advise the client to wear diapers. B. Advise to keep the perineal area neat and clean. Option C. Limit the intake of oral fluids. And D. Teach Kegel exercise. Answer is Option D. Teach Kegel exercise. Rationale. Kegel exercise. Ask the client to hold the urine while voiding. It strengthens the perineal muscles. This will gradually resolve the problem of dribbling of urine. Question number 3. The assessment of a client reveals abdominal distension, shallow respiration, steady pulse. Which electrolyte imbalance should the nurse suspect? A. Hyponatremia. B. Hypokalemia. C. Hypocalcemia. D. Hypernatremia. See the symptoms. Abdominal distension, shallow respiration, thready pulse. Which electrolyte imbalance should the nurse suspect? And the answer is Option B. Hypokalemia. Let's see the signs and symptoms of hypokalemia. There is a mnemonic, a sick vault. A for alkalosis and abdominal distension. S for shallow respiration. I for irritability. C for confusion. W weakness. A arrhythmia. L lethargy. T thready pulse. That is a sick vault. This is a mnemonic for signs and symptoms of hypokalemia. That is in hypokalemia. Alkalosis and abdominal distension occurs, shallow respiration, irritability, confusion, weakness, arrhythmia, lethargy and thready pulse. Question number 4. Which of the following drug causes arrest of the bone growth and staining of the teeth in young children? A. Ampicillin. B. Erythromycin. C. Ciprofloxacin. D. Tetracycline. Answer. Option D. Tetracycline. Rationale. Because of the effect, that is, because of the arrest of bone growth and coloring of the teeth, effect of this tetracycline, it is contraindicated in children below 8 years. This tetracycline arrests the growth of the bone of the children. Mainly because of this, it is contraindicated in children below 8 years. Question number 5. Which of the following medication warrant frequent eye checkup? Option A. Rifampicin. B. Pyrazinamide. C. Isoniazid. D. Ethambutol. Which of the following medication need frequent eye checkup? A. Rifampicin. B. Pyrazinamide. C. Isoniazid. And D. Ethambutol. These all are anti-TB drug. And the answer is Option D. Ethambutol. Ethambutol, its related side effects are loss of vision in one eye for 1 hour or longer, loss of color vision, blurred vision, pain on eye with movement. Because of this effect, it is also contraindicated in children below 6 years. Note the point, tetracycline and ethambutol are contraindicated in children below 6 years. Question number 6. Which of the following sign indicate digoxin toxicity? A. Yellow spot in vision. B. Gum hypertrophy. C. Hypotension. And D. Bleeding. Answer is option A. Yellow spot in vision. It is the major side effect, toxic effect of digoxin. Gum hypertrophy is usually seen with the side effect of phenytoin, that is Eptoin. It is an anti-seizure drug. Question number 7. Which of the following is false regarding magnesium sulfate therapy in eclampsia? A. It reduces the chances of seizure. B. It causes cerebral vasodilation. C. Calcium channel blockers can be given as an antidote in case of overdose. D. It relieves vasospasm by opposing the calcium dependent atrial constriction mechanism. Answer is option C. Calcium channel blockers can be given as an antibiotic in case of overdose. It is a false, because in the case of overdose of the magnesium sulfate, we are giving calcium gluconate. Let's see the other option. Option A. It reduces the chances of seizure. B. It causes cerebral vasodilation. With the cerebral vasodilation, it reduces the chances of seizure. And it relieves vasospasm by opposing the calcium-dependent arterial constriction mechanism. It is also true regarding magnesium sulfate, that magnesium sulfate relieves vasospasm by opposing the calcium-dependent arterial constriction mechanism. Calcium gluconate is given in overdose of magnesium sulfate, not calcium channel blockers. All other three options are correct regarding magnesium sulfate treatment. Which of the following is not a probable sign of pregnancy? A. Amenorrhea. B. Brackton-Hicks contraction. C. Ballottement. And D. Hagar sign. It's a direct question. Answer is option A. Amenorrhea. Let's see the probable sign and presumptive signs. Probable sign include Goodell sign, Chadwick sign, Hagar sign, Braxton-Hicks contraction and ballottement. That is all signs comes under probable sign. That is sign. Next, in presumptive sign comes under, in it comes an amenorrhea, nausea and vomiting, breast enlargement and tenderness, fatigue and back pain. These are the presumptive signs of pregnancy. Question number 9. Triple marker screening test in pregnancy usually involves the estimation of all except option A, alpha fetoprotein, B, human chorionic gonadotropin, C, estriol, D, inhibin A. Answer is option D, inhibin A. In triple markers, we are screening alpha fetoprotein, HCG and estriol. The quadruple screening, that is quad screen, we are checking for low AFP, low estriol, high HCG, high inhibin A. It is associated with high risk for Down syndrome. That is, in Down syndrome, low AFP, low estriol, high HCG, high inhibin A, we can identify. Question number 10. In a normal ECG, downward reflection is seen in option A, AVR, option B, AVL, option C, AVF, and option D, lead 3. Answer is option A, AVR. In normal ECG, downward deflection is seen in AVR and V1. AVR and B1, we can see downward deflection in ECG. Question number 11. How many lobes are present in liver? Option A, 2 lobes, B, 3 lobes, C, 4 lobes, and D, 5 lobes. Answer is option C, 4 lobes. Lobes of liver include right lobe, left lobe, caudate lobe, and quadrate lobe. Question number 12. Ependymal cells are located in A, cella tarsica, B, ventricles, C, pons, and D, medulla. Answer is option B, ventricles. Ependymal cells are neuroglial cells that lines the cavities of the ventricle and forms the part of choroid plexus and secrete CSF. That is, this ependymal cells secrete CSF. It is lining the cavities of the ventricle and forms the part of choroid plexus. These ependymal cells are neuroglial cells. Question number 13. A client is complaining of sharp knife-like chest pain that increases on inspiration. This may be a symptom related to option A, gastrointestinal system, B, cardiovascular system, C, respiratory system, and D, musculoskeletal system. Answer is option C, respiratory system. If there is any change in pain as per movement, it may be related to respiratory system and musculoskeletal system. In GAT and cardiovascular system, pain will not increase with the movement. But this characteristic pain is responsible for the respiratory system, that is chest pain, which increases with inspiration. So it leads to the clue that it is comes under respiratory system. Question number 14. Which of the following enzyme is most indicative of cardiac damage? A, LDH, B, troponin I, C, myoglobin, and D, creatinine kinase. Answer is option B, troponin I. Cardiac markers and their peak time approximately. Troponin test, it is the most sensitive and specific test. Up to 12 hours, it is has its peak in the blood. Next is creatine kinase test. It includes 10 to 24 hours. Lactase dehydrogenase, 72 hours. Myoglobin, its peak time is 2 hours, but it has low specificity. This lactose dehydrogenase enzyme is present in almost all body tissue, it will not be specific to cardiac injury. This creatine kinase is present in all skeletal muscle, but the creatine kinase isoenzyme, we can say it is specific for cardiac injury. Out of these four options, troponin is the most sensitive and specific indicator of cardiac injury. Question number 15. Which of the following client is likely to develop renal failure? Option A, a diabetic client with cardiac catheterization. B, a client on dialysis with upper respiratory tract infection. A postmenopausal woman with hypotension. D, a client with a pelvic inflammatory disease. Answer is option A, a diabetic client with cardiac catheterization. Due to compromised blood supply in diabetic clients, they are at risk for developing renal failure. In addition to this, in cardiac catheterization, we are using dye. This dye increases the likelihood of developing renal failure. So, this both, that is diabetes and dye, will contribute to renal failure. Question number 16. What is the color code of nitrous oxide cylinder in operation theatre setting? Option A, black. Option B, blue. C gray and D yellow. Answer is option B blue. The black color indicate nitrogen, yellow color indicate suction, gray color indicate carbon dioxide. Question number 17. Which of the following is not a complication of blood transfusion? Option A, metabolic alkalosis. B, hyperkalemia. C, hypercalcemia. D, iron overload. Answer is option C, hypercalcemia. In blood transfusion, note hypercalcemia, hypocalcemia occurs. The citrate, which is used as an anticoagulant in blood, that is the citrate in the blood bind with the calcium and it is excreted. So blood level of calcium will decrease and it lead to hypocalcemia. Hyperkalemia in blood transfusion occurs because of the hemolysis of the blood. Metabolic alkalosis occurs. The citrate undergoes hepatic metabolism and changes to bicarbonate. This is because of this metabolic alkalosis occurs. Question number 18. Which of the following is a tumor marker of breast cancer? Option A, CA19-9, B, CA15-3, C, immunoglobulin, D, CA125. Answer is option B, CA15-3. Rationale. CA19-9 is associated with colon and prostate cancer. Immunoglobulins are associated with multiple myeloma. CA125 is associated with epithelial ovarian cancer. Question number 9. Which of the following mask is used for precise titration of percentage of the oxygen? Option A, nasal cannula. B, simple face mask. C, non-rebreather mask. And D, Venturi mask. That is, which of the following mask is used for precise titration of percentage of oxygen? Answer is option D, Venturi mask. Question number 20. Which of the following is appropriate in Meniere's disease? Option A, high sodium, low potassium diet. B, limited sodium and normal potassium diet. C, normal sodium and normal potassium diet. And D, low sodium and high potassium diet. What happens in Meniere's disease? So, which option is correct? Which diet option is correct for Meniere's disease? Answer is limited sodium and normal potassium diet. Always remember that in Meniere's diet, we are giving low sodium diet. This high sodium and low potassium diet is given in Addison's disease. Question number 21. A client with manic episode is prescribed lithium. Which of the following is an ideal time for the sample collection? A, 12 to 24 hours after the last dose. 24 to 48 hours after the last dose. C, 48 to 72 hours after last dose. And D, at any time after the last dose. Answer is 12 to 24 hours after the last dose. Question number 22. Tablet clozapine was prescribed for a client with schizophrenia. The nurse should observe for which of the following serious side effects? A, granulocytosis. B, thrombocytopenia. C, hypertensive crisis. D, hypoglycemia. Answer is option A, agranulocytosis. Rationale. Clozapine major side effects include seizure and agranulocytosis. The minor side effects of clozapine include sedation, hypersalivation, orthostatic hypotension, tachycardia and constipation. Question number 23. Which of the following is not a complication of portal hypertension? Black tarry stone, hematemesis, ascites, and D, asterixis. Answer is option D, asterixis. Asterixis is a sign of hepatic encephalopathy. In portal hypertension, gastrointestinal bleeding occurs. That's why black tarry stool, hematemesis, etc. occurs. Because of the high pressure in the portal main system, ascites, because three-third space fluid shift occurs, which leads to ascites. Question number 24. Which of the following insulin has an average onset of action of 30 minutes? A. NPH, B. Regular, C. Lispro, D. Aspart. And answer is option B, regular insulin. Let's see the category, type of insulin, its onset of action, peak action and duration. Very rapid acting type insulin is, example is Lispro and Aspart. Onset of action is 5 to 15 minutes and peak action 45 to 75 minutes and duration is 2 to 4 hours. Rapid acting insulin is regular insulin, that is Humulin. Onset of action is 30 minutes, peak action 2 to 4 hours, duration is 6 to 8 hours. Intermediate acting insulin, example is NPH, neutral protamine H-done. Onset is 2 hours, peak action 4 to 12 hours, duration is 18 to 28 hours. Which of the following is not a sign of adrenocortical carcinoma? A. Pink or purple stretch mark in the skin, B. Excessive hair growth in the female, C. Atrophy of testes in men, and D. Weight loss. So the following is not a sign of adrenocortical carcinoma. Answer is option D, weight loss. Note weight loss, weight gain occurs in adrenocortical carcinomas. Question number 26. Who is the present secretary of Indian Nursing Council? Who is the present secretary of Indian Nursing Council? A. T. Dilip Kumar, B. Asha Sharma, C. K. S. Bharati, D. Sarvajit Kaur. Answer is option D, Sarvajit Kaur. Indian Nursing Council, President is T. Dilip Kumar, Vice President Asha Sharma, Secretary Sarvajit Kaur, Joint Secretary K. S. Bharati. Question number 27. Which of the following is expressed as proportion? A. Incidence, B. Prevalence, C. Maternal mortality rate, and D. Sex ratio. Answer is option B, prevalence. Rate is expressed in incidence, infant mortality rate are expressed per 100. That is rate. Incidence, infant mortality rate are expressed per 1000. That is rate. Proportion, prevalence, couple protection rate, etc. are expressed per 100. That is proportion. This ratio, maternal mortality rate, relative risk, sex ratio are expressed as ratios. Keep in mind that this incidence and infant mortality rate are expressed per 1000. That it is known as the rate. Prevalence, couple protection rate are expressed per 100. It is known as proportion. Maternal mortality rate and relative risk sex ratio are expressed as ratios. Question number 28. The number of reference curves in the growth chart recommended by WHO is A. 2 reference curve, 3 reference curve, C. 4 reference curve, and D, 5 reference curves. Answer is option A, 2 reference curves. Question number 29. The average anti-D immunoglobulin should be given at which week of gestation? A, 20 week of gestation. B, 24 week of gestation. C, 28 week of gestation. D, 30th week of gestation. Answer is option C, 28 week of gestation. The immunity derived from T lymphocytes. A, cellular immunity. B, humoral immunity. C, active immunity. And D, passive immunity. Answer is option A, cellular immunity. Thank you for being with us. Check our playlist and prepare accordingly. Thank you.